Hey guys, I am Chris from Lucky Gunner and welcome back. This is part two of how to use a semi-automatic pistol and the third video in our Shooting 101 series. If you didn't catch the first half of this tutorial on semi-autos, I will leave a link to that down below or above or somewhere. Anyway, in part one, we talked about the rules for safe gun handling and how to load and unload the pistol. Now we're moving on to look at how to fire a semi-automatic. Like I said last time, there are tons of different types of semi-auto pistols, and I can't cover all the details that are unique to operating each different model, so be sure to look over the owner's manual for your specific gun. When we left off last time, we had just finished loading the pistol. So we've got the magazine in, and there's a round in the chamber, and we're ready to shoot it. So this is the point where we will engage our safety or decocker if our gun has one, but we're going to talk more about that in just a second. Regardless of what kind of gun you have, you are going to grip it more or less the same way. So place the web of your dominant hand as high up on the back of the grip as you can get it. Keep your index finger straight and keep it up here on the frame or on the slide well away from the trigger. Wrap your other fingers around the front of the grip and get those as high up as you can get them. Your thumb can rest on top of a manual safety if you've got one that's right here. This gun doesn't have one, so I'm just gonna try and keep it clear of any of the controls that are back here. Now you can bring in your non-dominant hand. Blade your hand and kind of rotate your wrist downward so your thumb is pointing forward. The goal is to get as much of the meaty part of your palm in contact with this empty space on the grip as possible. So do that and then wrap your fingers around the front on top of your other fingers. You want the top of your index finger on your non-dominant hand to be touching the bottom of the trigger guard, like that. Point your thumbs forward, but you don't want to rest them on the slide because the slide needs to move freely and your thumbs might prevent it from doing that. You're gonna have to grip the gun a little differently depending on the size of your hands and the size of the gun, but whatever you do, don't put your thumb back here because when the slide comes back after you fire the gun, it's gonna really cut your thumb and that'll be no fun. Now, hold out your arm straight in front of you, but don't lock your elbows. Point the gun down at the ground in front of the target. This is the low ready position. When you decided to shoot, bring the gun up to eye level and squeeze the grip really hard with both hands. Now, at this point, you can move your finger to the trigger, press the trigger to the rear with steady, even pressure without moving the rest of the gun, and bang. Congratulations, you've just put a hole in something. In the split second after you fire, the slide will automatically move to the rear, a spent shell casing will fly out of the ejection port, and the slide will return to the forward position. Then you can fire another shot, and you can keep firing until you either decide to stop or the gun runs out of ammunition. In either case, when you stop shooting, place your index finger back on the frame away from the trigger and lower the gun to the low ready position. When the last round in the magazine has been fired, the slide will lock open. If it doesn't lock open, it's usually because you have been inadvertently holding your thumb on top of the slide stop. If that's the case, then you're only going to know the gun is empty when you press the trigger and nothing happens. So in that case, you will have to manually pull the slide to the rear and lock it open. Now remove the empty magazine and put the gun down with the slide open and the barrel pointed in a safe direction. Now you can load the magazine again and keep firing. That procedure will work fine if you have a striker fired or double action only pistol with no manual safety. But let's go back and look at some of the additional steps that you need to take if your gun does have a manual safety or a decocking lever. Manual safeties are most often located back here on the side of the slide. It could be on the right or the left side, like on this model 1911. In this case, the up position is safe and the down position is fire. When it's on safe, the trigger should be blocked and the gun is not supposed to fire, but safeties can fail. We never rely on the safety. We always have to follow the rules of safe gun handling. The reason a lot of these guns have manual safeties is because the trigger has a very short length of travel, which is very unforgiving if you get your finger on the trigger when it's not supposed to be, or you get something caught in the trigger guard like a chapstick or a drawstring from your jacket. It doesn't take much to discharge this gun accidentally. So we're only going to disengage the safety when we've got the gun pointed at target and we're ready to shoot. Now, unfortunately, with some pistols like this one, the slide does not work when the safety is on. So you will have to turn off the safety to load the gun and to clear it. But as soon as the slide closes, flip that safety back on and leave it on until you're ready to shoot or unload the gun. If your gun has a decocking lever, that might be located any number of places really, but you will often find it here above the magazine release, or sometimes it'll be like in this area on the back of the slide. You only find decockers on double action, single action pistols. When I rack the slide to load this gun, the slide cocks the hammer. So now I've got a really short trigger press, just like that 1911 we just looked at. But unlike the 1911, there is no manual safety. And I don't want to leave the trigger in this condition until I've got it pointed at the target and I'm ready to shoot. So I'm going to use the decocking lever to lower the hammer without firing the gun. Now the gun is still ready to be fired in this condition, but my first shot is going to have a long and heavy trigger press, like that, that requires a much more deliberate action to make it fire. After I fire that first shot, the slide is going to move to the rear and cock the hammer for me so that all my subsequent shots will have that light and shorter trigger that's a little easier to manage. Whenever I stop shooting, I lower the gun and I decock the hammer again. The longer trigger acts as kind of a safety on this gun, and I want to keep it decocked unless I'm actively shooting at a target. Some pistols have a decocker that also acts as a manual safety, like this Beretta 92 FS. The safety decocker is up here on the slide, and when I decock, the lever stays in the down position, which puts the pistol on safe. Or if it's already in the down position when I rack the slide, it decocks automatically. The trigger is now basically disconnected and it doesn't do anything. When I'm ready to fire, I have to disengage the safety and I still have to deal with the long, heavy double action trigger for my first shot. Notice here that the safety works in the opposite direction of the other safety we looked at. Up is fire and down is safe. This is the one type of pistol where I would actually consider using the manual safety to be optional. As long as you decock it, the longer trigger should provide enough of a hedge against an unintentional discharge. So if you want to disengage the safety after you decock, that is typically considered an acceptable practice with these guns. Okay, now that was a lot to cover. So let's review everything from part one and this video with a quick live fire demonstration. Here I happen to be using a double action, single action pistol with a decocker. So start by clearing the pistol. Remove the magazine, rack the slide, and push up on the slide stop to lock it open. Check the chamber and make sure it's empty. Put down the gun with the slide open and the barrel pointed in a safe direction. Load the magazine with as many rounds as you want to shoot. And now this is a good time to put on ear and eye protection if you haven't already. Insert the magazine into the gun, pull the slide to the rear and release it, engage the manual safety or decock the hammer. Get a firm two-handed grip with your index finger off the trigger. Bring the gun up to eye level and point it at the target. Disengage the safety if you have one. Put your finger on the trigger, press it to the rear with steady, even pressure. If you stop firing, take your finger off the trigger, safety on, decock, and bring the gun down to low ready. When the gun is empty, the slide will lock to the rear, remove the magazine, and put the gun down. If you would like to know more about how to effectively use a semi-automatic pistol, be sure to take a look at some of our other videos and blog articles. And of course, when you are ready to take that gun out and go shooting, get your ammo from us at luckygunner.com and have it shipped right to your front door.